Good evening. Today we are at Sambrahma Farms of Hosachinguru. There are many unique things about Sambrahma Farms. First of all, it is a farm which is being developed in a very, very sustainable manner. We are following centropic principles here. We generate a lot of biomass on a regular basis. Apart from emergent trees like teak or passion fruit and things like that, we also plant lot of high biomass plants like banana, Glericidia, Sesbania and things like that. So which grow very, very fast without much inputs, and this organic matter is chopped and dropped into the soil. So while doing that, when you chop and drop a branch of a green matter into the ground, what happens is first it forms part of mulching. So that means when the next day when the sunrise, when there is a harsh sun, so the soil moisture is preserved from evaporation. First step. Second step is because you have chopped and dropped a green branch, the nutrients that are part of the leaf will slowly soak into the soil. Because some of the branches are more than your finger size and plus, that also has got a lot of carbon. Now when you are doing these things in a repeated manner, you are adding moisture to the, preserving the moisture of the soil, you are adding nutrients to the soil, you are also adding carbon matter to the soil. So by this, the biodiversity improves at an exponential rate in the ground. This is a way of preserving the nature, one method of preserving the nature. Second method, what we are following in Sambrahma is that we are also picking up lot of native trees which are very, very naturally occurring in this area. So by doing that, what happens is, whether there is sufficient water you are providing, whether you are taking care of them or not, they know how to take care of themselves, because they survive here in this environment without anybody's intervention. So instead of you bringing some plants from outside, you incorporate the plants which are native to this place, so that sustainability angle will naturally come. So impact of all these things is the organic matter in the soil goes up very, very rapidly, and then the soil becomes spongy, responsive, ecologically good. It will be able to absorb a lot of water and charge the ground. And more importantly, because you are using mostly the rainwater, you are not drawing upon the subsurface water which is in the borewells. You don't use it as a first option. There's only a last option. So by doing these things, you add to the environment, not only consuming the environment. It is not like that I put a tomato plant seeds and then get tomato and harvest tomato and throw the plant. No, it's not like that. We are making the environment self-sustaining, regenerative and sustainable on a long run basis.
Hi, we're Ananas and we're an ecological landscape design firm. Today we're here at Sambrahma Farms by Hosachi Guru. We've done the master plan for this farm. Earlier this year when we met the founders of Hosachi Guru, they told us that they want Sambrahma Farms to be something different from their usual plantation style farms. They wanted us to bring in this whole systems thinking of how these different elements are interacting with each other and what is to look at this parcel of land as a whole instead of mini farms. So we came up with this design that was fed by this environmental study document. Over 20% of the farmland is this common area, which is, you know, all your lakes and water bodies and streams and wild zones, and it's for everyone to enjoy. And even each plot has its own boundary planting, which is going to be treated as a wild zone. Some of the plots are stream facing and they have riparian zone as a part of their land. We've spent the last 4 to 6 months just making observations, doing the environmental studies, collecting all this data and documenting it, and now we have gone into we finished the design and now we have gone into the implementation phase.
So in permaculture, we're guided by certain ethics and principles. The ethics that we work with, for example, are caring for earth, caring for people, and fair share. We also value diversity in a big way. So even with the planting that we're doing today, we look a lot at not only a diversity in terms of plants, but also diversity in terms of yields that we get out of the system.
What we're trying to mimic from these reference ecosystems, the forests that we are surrounded with, is to also have the larger vision of this project is to extend outwards in terms of the benefits of regenerative practices on land. So we also want to serve as a carbon sink and impact the kind of agriculture and the way people think of growing food in and around this region, and how to utilize water and how to harvest all of the rainwater that you get.
And also for the people who will be living here, they'll also feel like they're already part of sort of a functioning kind of ecosystem rather than coming into something that feels very just for just, you know, a human landscape in a more sort of urban or suburban kind of sense. The plants that we grow here can provide us with various other things, like including medicine and timber and you know, just beauty of various kinds. And it's a method that basically mimics the way that forest ecosystems function, because those are some of the most productive ones on earth and they also cycle their own resources.
Our primary focus was on passive systems of irrigation, and that's always our first strategy, because it basically requires no energy and time investment on our ends, except for the initial investment that we do in doing the earthworks as such. After that, it's all passively, managed. The land irrigates itself. It's able to capture all of the storm water.
We've designed this parcel of land for anyone who lives here to be able to enjoy and interact with nature here, and be a part of the process. It's not the kind of farm that you have to wait for yield and, you know, that is your only interaction. It's the kind of farm where you are integrated within it. All the pathways are designed for you, all the roadways, all the common areas, all your observation decks and machans. Everything is designed for the person living here to be well integrated and be one with nature.
Hi, this is Namita.
I'm Srikant. We are from Bangalore.
John, I'm from Bangalore.
Hi, my name is Vinay Babu.
I'm Rana. This is Agun, my wife. We are from Bangalore and we are at Hosachi Guru today.
This weekend, I think we decided we'll come here and we'll chill under the mango tree, sleep under the stars. We called Hosachi Guru and checked the availability. They said, yeah, absolutely.
And Hosachi Guru, when I first interacted with Vidya, we came, we saw Abhivruddhi, we had a nice organic lunch there, the hospitality was great.
Very small part of something so beautiful, something like a farmland where trees are grown and, you know, animals are taken care, and that is almost magical right now.
We stumbled upon Hosachiguru, which talked about providing farmlands at competitive prices. And this was a clincher for us. We heard a lot of radio ads. We talked to the company and booked an appointment to visit the farmland. And what we saw there was like love at first sight. We were impressed with the greenery around us. We went to the Abhivruddhi farmland where we could experience greenery, and the kind of management that Hosachiguru had brought in really impressed us.
The underlying statement for this is the caretakers or the facilitators are so ground to earth. In hospitality, I could say they are really great.
So this has been a fantastic journey so far, and we would like to continue and make this a worthwhile exercise for all of us. And I'm very happy that we have been associated with Hosachiguru, and I am proud to be a member of the Hosachiguru family.
So, as parents, we feel happy seeing our children happy. So I think there's no better experience I can give her than this. There are things like this which will give you much more happiness. It cannot be quantified, and I think everyone should do something like this in their lifetime.
Yeah, it's been a wonderful experience. We had a great time yesterday.